Hello, dear listener. This is the Mundane Matters podcast with Anup George. If you enjoy conversation and don't take offense at opinion, then this is the podcast for you.
Should I ask, start by asking you questions?
Oh,
when did this come?
Huh, yeah. Hey, so we started around like 7 episodes back.
No, big success. I'll sit there asking some questions.
Okay, we're good to go. 3, 2, 1. I love that beard.
Thank you.
I really love that beard. How long did it take?
This is 2.5 years.
And that's a commitment.
Before that, again, 2.5 years. I had almost this length. I went a little overboard, wanted to color this.
Mm-hmm.
Went to a saloon. He
wait, color
it thrice.
Okay.
To get it white.
Oh,
electric blue. Otherwise, it turns green. Right?
Correct.
You add blue to yellow. So he did that, and then here came my hand.
That is like a Game of Thrones character at this point of time. There is an actual character in Game of Thrones with a blue beard.
Yeah.
Did it work out though?
No. I had to cut. That's why I said. I had almost this length and unfortunately I had to cut.
Bleach destroyed it.
Am I supposed to look anywhere? Here?
No. I'm so chill. Right now it's just the two of us having a chill conversation.
Perfect.
So I saw this incredible picture of yours with your bike. With your beard around the end. That's when I was like, dude, that guy is like committed to another degree. To go.
That was the moment when I completed 1 lakh kilometers on my bike.
Yeah?
So that beard is covering a speedometer, which is showing 1 lakh, which is here also.
Kick ass. So since when have you been riding?
5 years. Five and a half years now.
And 1 lakh done already.
That's the advantage of being a freelancer.
Yeah, truly. See, the freedom of becoming a freelancer, I think our generation is the first one to start to realize. Like, you are like one off at that point of time. What do you think? Like,
were there a lot of... I became a freelancer at the age of 50.
Hi, sir.
I am 56 now. I'll be 56 on 21st of April.
Killing it. So, before that, what was life like?
Studio, home, nothing else. Then I started doing live gigs. So, it was airport, gig, airport, studio. Work and then home. So it was mad. I mean, never got time for myself in that earlier struggle to become something. And I'm done MSc in microbiology. So I'm not from this field. Just the passion for music got me here. So I self-taught. So it took longer.
How did that work? So because I'm assuming that technology as a whole back then when you started would be so vastly different, right?
It was, but it was that change was happening. I was that analog to digital shift was happening. So in a way I was fortunate to get into digital world straight away.
Correct.
It was hard but in a way,
because everyone else was also figuring it out, so then it became easier.
So it gave me little time.
What is your preference though, analog or digital?
Analog.
Far better.
But I realized it quite later in my life because I got in when it was digital, so I never got actual chance to compare A to B.
Correct.
A few years back, one of my friends started a studio with analog tape. And he invited me, so I had a session which was recorded much earlier. I just passed it through a tape and recorded back, and I
this is a world of this.
And it has character. Like if you put in low frequency, it makes it warmer, thicker. If you put high frequency, it adds sizzle to it. So I mean, it works differently. I never understood this before. I mean,
correct.
People used to talk about analog, warm sound, tape,
two-inch
tape.
Also because of the romanticization of the past, no?
It was, I only thought that. But when I actually heard 16 years after having my studio, after shutting my studio, I realized, what did I miss?
Exactly. Why did you shut the studio?
Actually, after a point, you are working with the same musicians, the same kind of music you are working with. After a point, it becomes too much, you know, doing punch in, punch out, starts getting it. I'm not a guy who will sit on the galla pe baithne ka dhande wala nahi.
Kaam nahi.
I came in for the passion of music.
Correct. Dukandari wala
scene nahi ki char log le lo job de do unko kaam pe lagao. I couldn't do that. I tried doing that. Not that I did not. I had a couple of assistants who I taught them and they were doing it handling. But I used to sit outside and ek saal
still
I tried doing that ki nahi. Main nahi baithega andar. I sat for an year outside, started doing live gigs, so that started attracting me more. I was getting opportunity to travel and possibility of being a freelancer and deciding which day you want to work.
Correct.
Whom you want to work, what kind of music you want to listen to, which artist you want to travel with, so that you like the music you listened.
Correct.
When I was working also.
Correct.
That got me to a point where I decided.
I'm very surprised that you said that, like, working with the same artist time and time again, because you've worked with many.
In a studio environment, you are catering to a similar genre or similar, like, you make a clientele, right?
Correct.
So the same client start coming to you. Then it becomes, and he, one particular person working with you, he has a set of musicians who regularly work with him.
Makes sense.
So, you know,
contacts of contacts.
That studio, wahan spiritual work hota. Yeah, wahan classical ke liye, that's a better studio. For pop, you should go to this. For rock, a band should go to. People start
putting
that label.
But does that actually make sense? Because an engineer, I would suggest, like...
It does happen some. I mean, it happens here.
Yeah, people specialize in one particular kind
of. That is there. I mean, if you take me, I cannot do Bollywood. Because Bollywood has never attracted me. When I moved from microbiology to music, I started audio cassette store. I am basically from Nagpur.
Oh, and settled in Pune there.
Yeah, I came quite late. 2002, I came to Pune. I had a studio at Nagpur for 6 years.
So
I started all my struggle there. I did my MSc in microbiology there. I worked as a microbiologist in Orissa. I worked as a diagnostic specialist selling pathology kits at Nagpur.
And
I was selling IV fluids, Vocart, all that. At one point, I had a band also. And I had a gig. And the sales came down. And
what kind of music did you play?
Rock.
Yeah?
Classic.
Oh, yeah.
Classic. I used to play bass, I used to sing.
Kick ass.
This is long back. 90s.
Yeah. The rocker vibe is completely intact with tattoos and
I
the
still
beard.
Listen to that only. I mean, I've not got out of Pink Floyd and Deep Purple and Eric Clapton and...
How do you feel that, like... So my generation pretty much listens to the same exact kind of music as well. Right? And that transversal kind of... creates a connection that is bar none, no?
Yeah.
Like you can literally walk into a place like FC Social and connect with the people on music instantaneously.
So even I was selling that, I was not selling Bollywood. In my cassette store, I used to go to these cassette companies, dig deep and take out Uriah Heep and, you know, albums like that on cassettes.
Okay, so cassette companies imported in bulk.
Yeah, no, MIL, for example, Music India Limited and HMV had the licenses to sell those rock albums.
Okay, yes, and then you just have to go, like, diving.
I used to go to them and get those albums, and I used to have that collection at my store.
Oh,
so a lot of engineering students were coming to Nagpur, private engineering students. So they all used to come to my store, you know, and searching for those. So I was catering to that. That was a niche market.
Beautiful.
So, beautiful.
So then... you shut store, you went like, bus ho gaya, abhi routine.
No, I was doing band, I mean, I was playing for a band also during that time. So, I started doing sound for it.
What is the name of the band?
There are lot many. I was playing for a band called Iron Maiden. Not Iron Maiden, it was called, not Iron Maiden. Inspired by Maiden. So Maiden Age was the name. There was a band called Cryogenics. Different names, different, short stints.
These can be found if one goes online and check.
Later on, you'll find a video also of a band called Ashwamedh. We released an album in 2000. I was in a video playing drums also. I had produced that album.
Always.
And I had played drums, not sequenced drums on a couple of songs. And when the shoot actually time came before releasing, the director said, I want a drummer.
Yeah.
We don't have a drummer yet because everything is sequenced.
Oh my God.
It's sequenced. So how... But I want a drummer. I want to show the band playing.
Correct.
I contacted a few of my friends who are drummers and one of them said, yes, I'll come. He never turned up. So last minute, chalo.
Let's go. Improvisation max.
So you'll find that video. It was a song called Hey Mama. And there was another song called Mezabin.
Yeah. I'll try to link that in the video also. Like, I would really... See... This is the beauty of conversations like this, is that I can throw a link right here and can be clickable and checked on that.
I can send you the link. It is there on
YouTube. That'd be pretty cool.
I think it is there. Yes.
So then you took up traveling for live events. So live events are flights still, or are they also on the bike?
Initially were flights. Then after I got the bike, then I started looking around. Hyderabad gig. One day's ride. So I used to call the manager, say that if I go there early one day prior, because I had to have one day in hand if I want to ride.
Correct.
I used to call them and say, can you give me a hotel? Don't pay me for the travel.
Oh.
One day I'll go. So I used to ride, stay one day prior, do the gig next day, and then trek up back. So I started doing that also. I went from here solo to a place called Mandawa in Rajasthan. 2 days ride. There was a festival in Mandawa. So I rode alone.
Beautiful. stories on the road. I mean, like, with solo riding, no, at least, I feel that, like, safety becomes a very big...
It's not... Not safety issues. Never had any safety issues in India.
That the roads are freaking filled with potholes.
Safety point of view, I wear proper gear. And we have something called as RSA, roadside assistance.
Correct.
So that gives peace of mind. So we have a contract with the company.
Mm-hmm.
So any breakdown, anything happens anywhere in India.
Mm-hmm.
So I just have to call that number.
Correct.
Within 3 hours, they send a vehicle that picks my bike and takes to the nearest Triumph showroom.
Kick-ass.
So I can get it repaired, do whatever, and I can continue my ride.
Let's talk about Bonnie. When did you get
Bonnie? That is 2015.
Yeah.
I always had a dream of having a Harley.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's been, you know, films and the gangs.
Yeah.
Long gang, all that.
Like road hogs sort of vibe.
So
yeah.
That was a dream. But like 16 years, I was busy setting myself, my life up and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So when I got first opportunity, I test rode a Harley. But I was very, very disappointed by the ride because it was getting heated and it was basically a showstopper. Before I used to go to a signal, people used to stop because of the sound. They used to wait and look, are you aagaya, kon aaya, kon aaya, you know,
correct,
all that.
Correct, correct.
And I used to feel like,
it's
wow.
It's a loud bike.
Loud
yeah.
bike and even the gear change is clunky. You know,
yeah? Which one was this? Which Harley was this?
Super low. Because that was the only one in budget.
That's
way out of budget, way out of budget. So it was a showstopper. I was not enjoying the ride at all. And one of my friends said, "Arey chal, main tere ko leke aata hu. There's a Triumph showroom. What is this Triumph? I have not heard the name of this brand also. Harley was one.
Is always yeah, like yeah. in pop culture also representation yeah, yeah.
Harley,
for Harley is
there. Harley Cruiser. Mm-hmm. And I went to not Ridermania. This is the other one, the biker pilgrimage.
Leh, Ladakh.
No. This Goa. There's a biking festival, no? There's always a
The bike.
I'm forgetting the name.
Yeah.
So I Pentagram were playing there.
Oh yeah. Huh.
And I went to do the sound early in the morning sound check, and I finished the sound and looked around. There were hundreds of Harleys all around me.
Correct.
I said, wow, I must have one.
Yes.
So that was like 13, and I shut my studio in 14, and 15 I started looking out for a bike.
Correct.
And with my friend, I went to Triumph showroom. I sat behind him. He was taking a test ride. The way the bike moved.
This is love.
Next week, I test rode myself.
Mm-hmm.
And next week, I had
that exact bike. Yes. As in, like, that exact model.
Yeah, Bonneville.
Beautiful. Bonneville. And that's where the Bonnie... I thought that the Bonnie and the Clyde wala sort of...
No, this is Bonneville because Triumph bike on Bonneville Salt Plains broke a speed record.
Mm-hmm.
That's why this bike is called
Bonneville. Damn. I thought that you called it Bonnie because there's a do chore on the road out there killing it and making it in life.
This is Black Beauty, I call it. It's a
beautiful. So, tell me this. Now, like, anyone who's ever heard of your name or I've heard from about you, so I said, dude, like, he works with the best kind of people, dude. And then they talk about their own genre, right? Their favorite genre. Now, the question that arose in my mind was, who's the best musician that you've ever worked with?
It's a difficult one. I've worked with a lot of musicians. I mean,
and that's...
KK is one guy I've traveled with extensively.
Mm-hmm.
He's a phenomenal guy, phenomenal human being.
Mm-hmm.
Shubha Mudgal, I'm traveling presently.
Correct.
She's one of the professional, the best person to work with.
And such positive energy.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And very, very clear in her.
Correct.
I travel with Chiyomani.
Mm-hmm.
He's extra...
Energy, full power.
And, you know, but it's always, you don't know what is going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
He is like that.
Mm.
He's that so extempore, so he never prepares any concert.
Mm-hmm.
He just goes in and feels his way.
So
that has advantage and disadvantage. Sometimes it is phenomenal, and sometimes it does not work. You
correct,
know?
Correct.
Just
correct.
That open-ended stuff.
Also, I've heard that like rhythm artists rarely prepare.
That's part of the moment. Presently, I'm traveling with Lucky Ali, Papo. They all are, absolutely phenomenal guys. Niladri, I was traveling with. He's a fantastic sitar player.
And
he's changed the sound of sitar by making an electric sitar.
Yes.
Called sitar. And
but
sitar.
Do you think that like that is better than the, like honest, personal
it's
opinion?
It's not better. It's a different feel.
Huh.
If you are playing a sitar like an acoustic sitar,
correct,
it has a different vibe.
Correct.
But on that also you can play a lot of rockish crews, and you can that one person can make a fusion concert out of it.
Correct.
You can have different sounds to it.
Yes.
But it goes through a guitar processor. So you have different options of adding delays and, you know, which on acoustic guitar.
I have been very curious about this, like Indian classical instruments have been the way they have been for
ages.
A long time, right? And like, so even like sarod, something that is this modern, like comparatively modern, is like some 200 plus years old. And I go like, why have there not been any improvements to the year, or just research? So that way it fits, definitely.
Yeah.
Right? But I still prefer the older.
I mean, he still plays that acoustic guitar, no? It's not that acoustics is that he does not play.
Correct.
It's that additional flavor which he uses.
To kind
he
of try and improve.
He definitely. Always travels with two. He plays acoustic, he starts the concert with acoustic and develops mood. Depends on how much time he has. Then he'll take the electric out, play a couple of songs and go back to acoustic. So it's a beautiful instrument.
And so, because I'm a huge fanboy, right? How was working with Agni in general?
I'll come back to it. Agni is where I started traveling live.
So that was the first? Oh, okay.
This is the first band. I actually started traveling as a live sound engineer for a band. Because Agni, Coco is a friend. When they had AGNI, I was a huge fan. They came to Nagpur to perform and we were supposed to open for them. So that was the first time I met Coco. Way back, I mean, that was Coco's first gig as Agni.
Amazing. Yeah.
So then he came to the studio and he met me around and said, we are starting a new band. The name, that time the new name wasn't there. And Mohan and me are starting a band and we want to record a demo with your studio free. Well, I'll make it free.
Of course.
It started like that. And then demo was made and then they were in my studio recording the album for a month. Like a whole month. Like everybody's with chill vibes and Coco used to come and play one solo, then thoda vocal dubo, after bete. You know, talk is happening. It was an experience in itself. So it happened over 1 month and it was fun. Then Coco one day about to finish the mix. You want to travel with us as live sound? Of course, why not? Chalo. So that's the start of my traveling as a live sound engineer for a band. Before that, I was doing live gigs, but for local vendors or maybe local event guys.
Correct.
Just to call me
the
here.
The scales are very different.
So then I got the opportunity to travel with them. So then it started, and I traveled with them for almost 10 years. But then dates started clashing, and I started traveling with a lot many artists. From the start, I was a freelancer because even at Agni's concert, I had studio commitments.
Correct.
So that was my priority. Slowly, that shifted to life, and then I made those as priority.
Why? What is the thing that you prefer with life? Like, what is better with life than with the studio?
See, life is again that moment. You are living in that moment. The gig, khatam. That is over.
Khatam.
I mean, maybe you have memories till that night.
Correct.
Next day morning, you're doing a different gig. Absolutely different acoustics.
Blank slate
different,
again.
Sound system. Different artist.
Correct.
So that gives you a high. I mean, every day is a different day.
That is so true.
And you are free. Basically, you have time for yourself. See, in a 365 day year, I work maybe actual work 80 to 90 days. And if you include travel and all that, so around 150, 160 days, I still have
kick-ass
half a year to
do. You're living the dream, you know that, right? Like everyone who's like right now going like, abhi thoda struggle karega, aur uske baad aisa karega na, khel ki life mast rahe. You're actually doing that without actually having to go through that cycle of, which is kick-ass.
Yeah. So that's always my wife, always. I used to work for 12 hours in a studio, 18 hours in a studio. So go home I would come, reach home early in the morning. And my daughter is going to the school, her auto rickshaw has not come. I see my wife getting ready to drop her. Why are you dropping? You work for whole night, why are you going? I'm not tired, I am not working. I am in music, I love
what I'm doing.
So basically I have to you go and sleep, I'll drop her. Then I have to come and sleep.
Perfect.
So it was like that. That energy is always there because you love what you do.
How has music over the last 20 years, let's say, changed? What do you think? Because the way we process music has changed so phenomenally.
In what context you want? Because there are different aspects. What changed for Bollywood is all the indie artists came in they Correct. Changed the whole Bollywood. Correct. What was Bollywood in 90s?
Mm-hmm.
That all Dholak and those typical grooves and the typical melodies, and it was like one song, second song, you couldn't differentiate.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, it was phenomenal.
Correct.
There was one period where there was one formula,
mm-hmm.
absolutely one formula. One typical groove, one typical melody, and the same thing was happening. There was nothing. All that was happening.
Mm-hmm.
There was nothing else happening. And then indie, there was indie scene. When I had a store, that was the first time pop music was having 10 to 12% of the
market share.
Market share. Yeah. It has never happened.
Correct.
It happened for that prime, Magna Sound, Bremen music and all that.
That was the best time.
That was the best time. Diler Mehndi happened.
Yes.
And, you know,
killed it.
Duba Duba Rehta Hoon happened.
Mm-hmm.
Agni was there.
Big, Indian Ocean was.
Indian Ocean was there. I mean, Indian Ocean is there.
Mm-hmm.
I've
come to Indian Ocean for that.
Because I have been working with them. So that's a separate story. So I'll come to that again. But Agni, what is that? Duba Duba was the band.
Yeah, Euphoria.
Euphoria was the other one.
Mm-hmm.
Mohit Chauhan's band.
Huh. Okay. Huh.
So that happened and Euphoria happened and there were so much happening. Made in India, video started coming.
Yes.
And it was like it went here and then suddenly dropped.
Do you think that the fact that Bollywood is so commercialized or caters to the lowest common denominator has something to do with this?
Yeah, they have a bigger screen. They have 70 mm screen. And for their videos, for that music video, they are Shah Rukh Khan acting.
Yep.
You know, so the scale is huge. The amount of money that goes into making of it is huge.
Correct.
The reach is huge. The promotional budgets are huge. So the reach is much, much more
mm-hmm.
than any indie artist can even think about.
Correct.
So all these indie artists started getting
moving
into music
slowly.
And the music changed. So the positive part of all this is the Bollywood music changed.
Correct.
And I can listen to Bollywood music now. I listen to the old ones,
mm-hmm.
60s, 70s, very melodious stuff.
Correct.
Beech mein I stopped listening
Completely
to anything.
Bad.
Now I can go back and listen to, you know, Ram Sampath and...
So there are a few gems, definitely, right?
But
majority of Bollywood music right now is very... I feel that it's like a behemoth that is consuming, like, really good indie artists into that.
Yeah, yeah. That is true.
There is commercialization of their art form.
Survival again. And you know, big stage,
makes
big
it.
Money,
Correct.
All that. All
I mean, like, I would love to have like a regularity of like bands like Indian Ocean, Agni, and there are so many more.
Well,
like,
I'll tell you, Agni, Indian Ocean, I was coming to Agni Ocean. Indian Ocean been performing for so many years.
Correct.
Rahul Ram was a judge in a reality show.
Mm-hmm.
His face was seen, and the appeal changed.
Correct.
You know that one. Then they did. Bande, that movie was banned and all that,
all
but that song really reached people. I mean, they cannot finish a show without singing that song.
Yeah, for sure.
Whatever
everywhere
they have to sing. They have to. And they can't get away. It's like that. So that has only reached so much, no?
Correct.
Then album. They have done so many albums for over the years.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, one song, one can
changes
the whole thing.
That is true.
So they are also a great bunch of guys we work with. Phenomenal.
I've actually had some time with them to chill. One of my friends is like good friends with them. Works in radio, so old school connections. They came over to his house and I self-invited.
Yeah,
like, "Arey, I'm bringing booze. Let's sit and chill." So, which is your favorite venue though?
My favorite venue is Shut. Blue Frog.
Oh yeah.
That is one of the
which
best
one,
venues. Blue
which
Frog,
one?
Bombay.
Bombay, no?
Yeah, yeah. Yes. That was by far the best venue because it was made with a concert in mind. Everything was around that.
Correct.
Hard Rock is the worst venue because
it
that is the
made
last thing.
With space
the
in
last
mind.
Thing on anybody's mind.
Correct.
You know, so the whole perspective changes. Blue Frog was made with passion. The system, the people who were working there, it was a different experience going there and doing a gig.
And there are so many cultural points, high points. That we as a country are benefiting from that have started at Blue Frog.
Yeah.
So the comedy scene also started at Blue Frog.
Yeah.
The Rockers used to be
Padik
at Blue Frog.
Earlier it was Raspberry Rhinoceros in my earlier time.
Uh-huh.
And what is that? Rang Bhavan.
Huh.
I used to come all the way from Nagpur for Indie Rock, whatever that, Independence.
Yeah.
I have seen old Agni perform there, then Rock Machine perform there,
mm-hmm.
and Brahma and all those people perform there. Rangbon, I had seen one fantastic concert of a band called Silk, which was Louis Banks, Shivamani, and Shankar Mahadevan.
Best!
Phenomenal that was.
Amazing.
Amazing experience.
So, Louis Banks' ka Susegad, have you heard? Sneha Kanwalkar did this show on MTV.
Okay.
And she went around Goa collecting different sounds and made a song. The lyrics are the Wikipedia entry for Goa.
Okay.
So Goa is a place in India. It is the smallest state in area. All of that is lyrics. Okay. And Louis Banks uplifted that to another level.
I will definitely go and check it out.
It is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful music. So that freedom now has come in with technology. I feel like a Sneha Kanwalkar going around recording samples and bringing back and mixing. That has changed the way anyone interacts with. I have so many friends who've set up studios like within their homes, which never was the case. And that, what do you think? Has that improved music? Has that worsened music? Has that reduced the quality of the musicians and the technicians?
No, I mean, if you listen to Billie Eilish, that album which got 8 Grammys is recorded in home. All basic stuff.
Correct.
You know, but you know, it doesn't matter. It is what you're putting out.
Makes sense.
I mean, if you look at it, not a single mix, a fantastic sounding mix has sold an album. It is the melody and the music that's it.
That
I will come to... I can't say this sounds better, that sounds better. That was super to listen to, but that doesn't reach more. Or, you know, it's a positive point to have a fantastic mix. But if you want to reach that, first thing is what you need is a good melody, a good song, good lyrics. Then everything else is ornamentation.
Comes in.
It's all ornamentation and making it better. But if that basic element is not there, how people don't like it.
And the focus on true sound has increased so much of lately with like the improvement in the headphones technology and whatnot. Like there's always that chase, but I don't think that we have context for it. Like, so could you give us a few recommendations? Like listen to this particular song or this particular song.
About new stuff I hardly listen to.
Old stuff.
Go back. So, I just put Pink Floyd on and I'm gone. And even if you listen to Eric Clapton's the last album, like Pilgrimage, or even after that one blues album he came out with, I Can Play, or so, I mean, the drummer, he's using the new technology also. He's programmed some drums and he's played some stuff. And it's fin. I mean, the grooves are so good.
Okay.
You know, the newer generation does it, but you know, that is something else. You know.
I often say that the internet has given us the ability but taken away the option. So, like an encyclopedia, you can flip through pages and find something new. Here, you can find anything but you need to know what to Google. That's why I always ask people for recommendations, ask people to like give a general direction, be that like index on the encyclopedia to go like, hey, pointing in this direction, not telling you exactly what to do, but please go explore.
Yeah, I mean, when I started this sound engineering, I had one Pro Tools ka manual. I had no connection. I don't have a guru.
Correct.
Nobody was there to teach me. I mortgaged my house. Me and my partner Anand Korekar, we mortgaged both houses, took loan, convinced bank for 1 year to give us loan, State Bank of India with high interest rate. Went to Bombay, search for what to buy, what is the latest.
And this is with no training at all.
No. Just this is the start of digital media. One of the first few to inquire about Pro Tools. I was the 10th in India to buy Pro Tools at Nagpur. Everybody said, hey, kon pagla ho tu, aaya
exactly.
He is doing all this. And I said, nahi, mereko, whatever latest technology, agle 10 saal jo chalne wale, that I want to buy. Yes. I don't know why something which is going to go away in 5-10, you know, 1 month, few years, which happened. The analog technology went away like,
in a snap.
Just like that.
Yeah.
1-2 years, it was gone. So then I learned, I used to check manual and I used to, there is a funny incident. I didn't know how much memory is required to record a song. It was a digital hard drive, 1 GB SCSI hard drive. I bought for 20,000 rupees. So I had 1 GB SCSI hard drive. There were 16 tracks and I was recording in Kavali. So the guys are sitting, all sitting in
that baithaka.
Sab ek saath baithe, mic lagaya, recording chalu, some whatever 10, 12, 13 tracks I was recording. And they sang for 20 minutes and my hard disk was full.
Oh,
it takes 5 MB per minute per track. I had no clue about it.
So
first day, first recording, I stopped after one song. I said, khana khane jao.
Abhi
I had ADAT. So I formatted a VHS tape. ADAT tape. It used to take real time, 40 minutes to format. Transferred everything from hard drive to that ADAT. 8 and 8 tracks, so 40 minutes.
What?
And then I was ready with this.
Oh my God. And that's how you did it constantly.
Initially. Then I realized, no, this is not, I can't do this.
Correct.
So I used to take the main tracks on Pro Tools and others. This was in sync on ADAT. So I bought a lot of VHS tapes.
Huh.
8 tracks used to go there and I used to record. So that's how I used to manage my data.
Entire.
Then I had to buy a hard drive later on.
Really? What? No, so this something like this is outlandish for someone like.
And that time, internet, I had to pay 500 rupees for 5 hours. If I paid together, I used to get 1 hour extra.
Oh my
God. If I paid 500 rupees, I used to get 600 rupees worth of time. That's 6 hours in a cyber cafe. And the speed was like...
Really,
to search one page and read through it, it used to be 1 hour.
Correct.
So,
so my father has a pamphlet at home. It says, now BPL with their new technology, only 2 rupees incoming. And I was like, wait, what? Incoming ke charges lagte the?
8 rupees was incoming and 16 rupees was outgoing.
Oh.
16 rupees was outgoing. And the phones were used to look like a brick. And you could hit
Motorola. Yeah. I still remember that entire year. It's such a beautiful, feeling. And this exactly, right? Where everything right now can be done on a phone. There are people mixing songs.
Yeah,
of course, quality is questionable, but on the phone.
Yeah, yeah.
And I feel that reduces one's focus, one's purpose of a particular thing to that degree, because options hazaar rehta hai, tab wo exploration nahi aata. Like when you were talking about your journey with tape, with analog instruments and then putting in that money to the... I see it visually, like you turning knobs and stuff like that. Right now it's all just this and it takes
There are advantages of it. At home, I'm traveling, I can still put in my ideas through and I have references. To create one loop, I used to take a lot of time.
Mm-hmm.
Now I have ready reference loops. I can select a loop and I can concentrate on melody. I mean, advantages if you take it are not many.
But that's also because you've been trained with the mindset of the older, with the ability of the new. Right now, because ability max.
When the sequencer came, me and my partner were sitting to understand how to sequence. They have absolutely no clue.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't know what crotchet is, what quaver is, and there's to be signs like that and where to search, how to find.
Mm-hmm.
Manual kholo, ye dekho, ek loop banane ko, 2-3 ghanta ek loop banate the. Tick, dhoop, dalke, and then it's to play back. Ye to galat ho gaya. Ye timing, idhar hona chahiye. So all that. That's how we used to make loops, basic grooves to start with.
Correct.
Start
any
composition or whatever. And now it's abundance, it's happening.
Mm-hmm.
So it is an advantage and a disadvantage.
Correct.
Both.
If you like the show, then show your love by doing the usual YouTube things and following us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. We are the Mundane Matters podcast on Monday.
What is the genre that you're exploring now?
Listening to or?
Just like listen to, heard one song, found it interesting. Probably are looking forward to exploring it.
Names I don't remember. I just so that's why I like Spotify.
Mm-hmm.
I put in interests and then just start playing.
Algorithm starts.
I basically, I just love. And mostly I now listening to music is only when I'm traveling and not on the bike.
Oh, so you don't listen to music on the bike?
Absolutely not. I listen to the sound of the bike and I'm concentrating on riding. In India,
you cannot
listen to music and have fun and suddenly someone will come in front of you.
I'm like, are gaya aa gaya.
Could be anything. The guy ka to scene, I was coming from Udaipur and I was riding at 100. It was a cement road. There was absolutely nobody. Okay, so I'm 100-120. I'm
allowing my.
Suddenly I see, it's a do aya. Because divider ke mein jhaad the. It was all nicely covered. So I just saw, it's a do bahar aaya. It's a do hi hai. Koi tension nahi. Idhar se kaha, thoda idhar ka nikla. So, 4, 8, the full family walk.
Tabela khol diya.
By the time I could brake and stop the bike, I was right here. Right here.
Oh.
And also, usne aisa kiya to mera handle theek.
Oh my.
Survived. That's even without no music and I'm concentrating still.
Imagine if you were listening to music and lost in that thought.
Like I'm riding, recently I was going to Ahmedabad and I was riding in the middle of the highway and one buffalo ran on the, he went wild. He came halfway on the highway and went back. fully scared. I mean, क्या करूँ?
Yeah, sweating through and through.
And I'm trying to gear down, try and find a way to get out, and but it went back. So, okay.
Oh my God.
So it's like that. So yeah. You never know. So you can't listen to music while riding, doing all this.
Man. So that is, see, again, difference in like approach and opinion, right? I've been thinking of like ki wo helmet mein invest kar leta hai, wo
jo that is for communicating.
No, the sound wala options are also available now.
And
like
also,
you can start playing.
The speakers are right, yeah, far away.
Correct.
So in the helmet, it doesn't sound good. There's no low frequency sense. Coming in. It sounds like tick, 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 tick. I just hate it.
So
I wear headphones though, but I don't use those speakers. But that is for communication only.
Correct. So, do you have like a biker gang group, friends?
We have lots of, I made lots of new friends, which have no connection to the world I live in, as a profession.
Correct.
And they're absolutely like from, someone is an IT guy, someone is interior, some, there are a lot of shippies who I ride with because
correct.
Those are my kind because when they come to
they
Pune,
completely come.
They are like me free.
Perfect.
They can ride anytime. A lot of shippies are my friends and a lot of IT guys who can work from home and also do a morning ride and, you know,
make a call
in the middle and all that. So
that,
those kind of friends I have. So I made absolutely new set of friends, which who is ride with me. It's fun. That's one big
advantage. Bike life, I really am very curious about. Because like you go to a place and if you have something to do at that place, like with you, it's live sound recording. It makes the journey itself so much more like, okay, now I went there, I had an adventure here, fulfilled it, went further. Because that chase, I feel, is very unique to when you actually have a purpose. Otherwise, kya hota hai? Idhar se udhar gaye, haan, dekh liya, mast, chalo wapas. Wo nahi, kuch ek aur add ho.
Adventure is there because, see, at the age of 50, when you buy a super bike, which you have never ridden before, in your younger age, even riding smaller bikes and ghar se office kiya hai, learning is a process. Again, I had to learn how to ride a 225 kg bike. How to
lean and turn
and all that. So it took me long time.
How to fall is something that is taught.
Fall after 5.5 years I failed. That time I never failed.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I met with an accident recently.
It is surprising.
I met with an accident recently. Coming from Lonavala and purse was right ahead of me. It took a left suddenly on the express highway. Towards express highway. And I had no clue. He's going to turn. And I had a little brush and then I lost my balance. So that happened now. But I am like in 1 year from the time I bought my bike, I went to Leh Ladakh.
With a friend.
वो करने गए. सही है. I had stock tires. I didn't know anything about it. I didn't know how to ride on a slopes with mud and downhill.
Possibly ice, possibly.
Connected. So my friend Ashwin was with me. So अबे break मत दबा. Front never.
Crail lock.
Front ने तो मैं करूँ क्या? सामने गाड़ियाँ घुस जाओ उसके अंदर. All that. But learned and now I started enjoying more because I'm confident on my bike.
Correct.
And it's just getting better and better.
Kick ass. Which are the best roads? Which is the best trip?
I like, earlier I used to feel scared on twisties. Now I need twisties. I get bored on a straight road. Earlier I used to love to go to Ahmedabad because that one huge big road.
Just bail out the street.
Chalao. But now it's like, are yaar, bore ho gaya.
I want to go. I'm
going to Spiti in September.
Amazing.
So, that is calling me again. I did once. But now I want to go with
again, thoda aur
confidence and I want to stay in Kaza for more time and explore places around.
They always say now, ki if you want to learn patience on the street, go to Mumbai. If you want to learn how to avoid idiots on the street, come to Pune. That's what the entire...
No, now Bombay has all the idiots from all over the world. All over India, settled in Bombay.
That's a good and bad thing of Bombay.
No, there was one time when if you change lane, you have to pay fine. And I have done that. On a M80, I'm going. My uncle's M80 in Bombay. So... suddenly I thought, अरे इधर नहीं इधर जाना है and I changed my lane. There was a pull cop. क्या हुआ? ची लेन चेंज किया. बोले ये तो हम नागपुर में तो ये ऐसा लेन ही नहीं कॉन्सेप्ट ही नहीं, ये सब क्या बोल रहा
है. So I was caught for danger driving.
अच्छा.
Okay. In Bombay. Okay. For changing a lane at a signal. So my car was at a standstill 10 kilometers की स्पीड पे. And he goes aside में गया. हाँ. तुम्हारा माइट है क्या तुम्हें क्या करा तो था. मैंने कहा है सर. डेंजर ड्राइविंग. मैं इतना फट गया वहाँ पे, सीट बेल्ट निकाल के बाहर निकाल के बात करना चालू की डेंजर ड्राइविंग का है सर, डाचा स्पीड पर हो तो. दैट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ. So which are the gigs that you have lined up aage ke liye kuch aisa hai?
Go to Hyderabad on Sunday, Shivamani. Then I'm starting traveling with Jubin Nautiyal now. Mm-hmm. It'll be the first gig I'll be doing in Jamnagar.
Mm-hmm. Best young musician, something on those.
Yeah. Very melodious, very. I love soft. I don't like to travel people who do dance, you know.
Okay.
That kind of music. I just hate that. I'm not good engineer to do that because I don't like that music. That's
you need to like it to truly give your all
for
it.
If you want to add something to that music, you need to like it. If you're doing it as a job, then anything comes. If you're doing it just for money, then it is. Whoever is giving me more money, I'll go there and do it. I pick and choose artists who I travel with. I mean, whenever there's an offer, like I have tried doing a lot of artists, but I've also said no to a lot of people. Because I cannot understand that genre. I can't add to that genre. I cannot add by it being on the concert.
Correct.
I'll take away. You know?
Makes sense. So, what are your opinions on like these huge music festivals that have like really picked up over the last 10 years?
I've been part of NS7 from the start.
The beginning.
Yes. I was at N2010, Pune, NS7. I was handling the Duvaristi. That's where I did Indian Ocean and there were lots of bands on that. So, earlier I used to love doing it because that is to test you. You know, you have to go there at 6 o'clock. Sound check, 5 bands, 6 bands, 1 hour gap, and do all the bands again. I mean, this concert. Festival used to start. Said, do sound check, changeovers, lines. There were like 100 lines, you know, so many bands and different setups, and it was to test you. So every year I used to do that once to, you know,
just
getting out of that comfort zone. Ek hi artist hai, so you exactly know what is needs to be done. Aisa wala nahi. You go there and test yourself.
And venues in India must be like so much more jugaad oriented at that point of time, especially. Right now, though, they have like a very set team.
A vision. Vijayanayar had a vision. He went to all the festivals that were happening abroad and studied them, and he wanted to get that culture in India.
Correct.
So it had a absolutely artist focus, music focus, technology focus.
Okay.
There were no compromises done. The equipment that we got was fantastic. There was a stage crew. Stage crew meaning there were people who were just writing down the change in the stage setup.
Amazing.
There are people who are writing down input changes. This has never happened in India. No?
Correct.
There are no numbers also. I mean, before time, एक गीग में गया मैं साउंड चेकिंग somebody else the artist किया हमारे ये नहीं मेरे को सेटअप चेंज करना है I took out all the cables from the microphones I had already set up and I said okay no problem we'll keep it back but the guy had not written any numbers so I had to go back start all over again because he didn't know where what was coming from where
yes
but I've worked with people like that also to absolutely everything is labeled every cable is labeled from which channel, where it is going, what instrument, everything is labeled. Now it has improved so much, very much that it is fun. And technology wise also, and equipment wise also, all the smaller vendors also have trained staff with them. So it is easier to work now. Earlier it used to be madness. I used to run from console to stage to sort shoes out. Now I don't know.
So this India versus foreign like conversation is from like a conversation that I'd heard of Vijay Nayar's about like him. He traveled with Pentagram, no? I think
he was for the manager for Pentagram from the start.
Correct.
Youngest.
Exactly. Like, and him being that age at that point of time and coming through with such an ambitious project, that is culture in like.
And that shows, no, because that is the only place where tech rider was given to the team. You send a tech rider, you will get.
Correct.
If you're not going to get something from the tech rider, you will get a call saying that, boss, I don't have this, I'm going to give you this. Otherwise, I have gone to concerts where on phone, sab mil jayega, sab hai, tech rider, sab hai sir, wahan jaake kuch nahi hai, nothing. Every chota stranger ka cube hai. I have done gigs like that. I have gone to Northeast where first gig with Vijay Nayar. He was managing Raghu Dixit also that time.
Oh yeah.
And Raghu, I came to know through Agni. And Raghu called me one day and I have a gig in Guwahati, I need you. Will you be able to travel? I said, okay. I went to Guwahati and me and Vijay were having food. He said, we'll go and check out the system. We had sound check at 6:37. Afternoon we went there. There was a local band's competition was happening.
Correct.
And it was sounding horrible. That whole thing was sounding absolutely horrible.
Yeah.
So then I went in, I said, where are the amps? केम अलॉन्ग विद मी, सर स्टेज के नीचे का पर्दा उठाया, नीचे से सब एम्प्स लगे हुए थे, उधर से खुली वायर जा रही थी, इट वॉज इन शैम्बल्स, सर व्हाट सिस्टम डू यू हैव, तो उधर पर्दा लगा था उसके पीछे देखा तो देयर वाज अ स्ट्रेंजर क्यूब इन द पीए, देयर 15 डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ स्पीकर, व्हाई हैव यू पुट ऑल दिस, 10,000 वाट देना था, दैट्स द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विद, मैं जो मिला उसने सब ला के रखा था, घर का स्पीकर, ये स्पीकर, एवरीथिंग वाज देयर,
सब ला के
रखा, एंड द मिक्सर, देयर वाज एनालॉग मिक्सर एंड देयर, ये इसमें से ये स्पीकर रन कर रहा है, इसमें से ये स्पीकर रन कर रहा है, एक ग्रुप आउट में से ये स्पीकर रन हो रहा है, इट वॉज लाइक मैडनेस. विजय बोला, नितिन इफ यू से वी विल नॉट डू दिस गिग,
हाँ
विजय आई हैवंट कम ऑल द वे हियर नॉट टू डू गिग, आई विल फाइंड अ वे टू डू दिस, जस्ट यू विल हैव टू गिव मी दैट टाइम. स्टेज गियर वॉज सॉर्टेड, सो सेड एज लॉन्ग एज द बैंड इज कंफर्टेबल ऑन स्टेज आई विल मैनेज दिस, आई विल गेट साउंड आउट ऑफ दिस, बट यू विल हैव टू गिव अ लिटिल मोर टाइम, दैट आई कैन गिव यू, बट इफ यू टेल वी कैन गो बैक, सो नो नो गोइंग बैक. सो आई वेंट इन, एक 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 आफ्टर दिस कॉलेज थिंग वॉज ओवर देन आई वेंट इन, चला ऑन कर, ये नहीं चाहिए, ये नहीं चाहिए, 25% ऑफ द सिस्टम आई यूज्ड, इट वॉज गुड इनफ फॉर दैट प्लेस, विच
द क्वालिटी ऑफ द साउंड, हाँ
दे वर गुड साउंडिंग स्पीकर्स, एंड आई मैनेज दैट गिग, फ्रॉम देन ऑनवर्ड्स विजय बिकेम
लाइक फुल भरोसा,
सेवन नितिन
ठीक है
आई वांट यू देयर, इट्स लाइक दैट, सो ऑलमोस्ट 10, 11 years associated with festival. So festival is fun. It's a different kind of vibe.
And it brings a lot of people awareness about the up and coming artists. No?
And what Vijayanaya did was, it's an interesting thing. Initially, each stage had one genre. So Diwali stage had fusion bands.
Correct.
Soft kind of music. Then there was a black arena where metal bands and were playing. Then there was one indie stage where new artists, singer-songwriters kind were coming. And he, after 3-4 years of this, he swapped artists. So he had one rock act on a Diwali stage.
So that there is
and
like
so
an introduction.
These people who are waiting for a metal band to perform, they just get a taste of this music also.
Correct. And so that is such a...
It's a fantastic idea.
I love people who do this. Yeah. You know, who are like, hey, you know what? I'm not going to tell you what exactly to think, but I'm going to nudge you in that direction.
This is a fantastic music. The festival is, I mean, really, really, really
best
helped
festival.
Me a lot. And, you know, I've done everything. I got a chance to do mix Wailers, which is Bob Marley's band.
There Wait, was what?
Bob Marley's band, but new there was only one bassist who is from that time.
Original.
Okay. So he didn't come for the soundcheck. And the drummer is playing kick-ass, and then somebody said, the drummer didn't come. What happened? उसको वीजा नहीं मिला, हु इज दिस गाय, ही इज अ परक्यूशनिस्ट, मेकिंग कैश ड्रम्स, ओके, सो आई साउंड चेक फिनिश्ड, एनीबॉडी हु वाज फ्री यूज्ड टू प्ले बेस, ओके, सो साउंड चेक टाइम,
सो इट्स दैट इंटरचेंजेबल, हां
वो सब हो गया, साउंड चेक फिनिश्ड, देन व्हेन दे एक्चुअली केम टू परफॉर्म, वन ओल्ड गाय फ्रॉम द ओरिजिनल वेलर्स, ही कुडंट वॉक, ही केम विद स्टिक्स, वॉकिंग लाइक दैट, ही केम ऑन स्टेज, सैट, ही वाज सिटिंग ऑन द साइड, एंड व्हेन द एक्चुअल गिग स्टार्टेड, ही वॉक्ड, stood for 1 hour and played the game, and the what sound changed, you know, he was growing so fucking
amazing,
absolutely amazing, I mean that was one show, and all Papa One and everybody was they are listening to that band, and they,
yes,
how good is sounding, but I'm not doing anything, it's all coming from there, I've just put the faders on,
so this is
so
magic,
good. That is magic, you know. That's one incident. Another incident, I was in Shillong, again, Northeast. There was a band called, there was a punk rock, for Iron Maiden's first vocalist who left Iron Maiden. He started a punk rock band, I'm forgetting his name. Anyway, Paul Diano. So his gig was there. And Coco was handling sound contract one. He was a vendor also.
Correct.
So he said, we have to go to Shillong, there's a Paul Diano gig. Okay, went there. Paul Diano's band came, they were called AK-47. Swiss band was backing Paul Diano. They came, how much disciplined they were. You know, the guitarist came, fiddled with his amp for some time. I heard few noises. Standing there. Imagine for a sound check, a guitarist standing still without playing. Same thing with the bassist, he came, tune. Can I hear the kick? Doop, 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 doop. Snare, ta, talu. And then, okay,
That's it.
Can I hear the guitar? All that happened? Good. What discipline. I finished the sound check in 15 minutes flat. Because I didn't have to tell, hey, band karna bhai, rokna mere ko drum sunna hai. All that did not happen. It was that 15-20 minutes of sound check, kick ass, everybody happy. And even when I'm talking to somebody, do you want more guitar? More. Okay. I mean, they were absolutely focused on the sound check. They were telling me what they wanted, how much they wanted. Here, अरे मेरे को गिटार नहीं आ रहा है बड़ा मैं बड़ा रहा हूँ ही वुडंट इवन लुक एट मी
करेक्ट
ही विल बी बिजी लिसनिंग
देयर इज नो अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द अदर पर्सन्स
सो इट वाज सो इजी फॉर मी एंड आफ्टर द फिनिश साउंड चेक इट इज एनालॉग बोर्ड आई सेड द ओपनिंग बैंड आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू टच एनीथिंग फ्रॉम हियर आई कैन नॉट डू आई डोंट हैव एक्स्ट्रा लाइंस आई वुड हैव एडेड आई एम फिनिश विद लाइंस सो एनी बैंड कमिंग इफ ही इज गोइंग टू यूज द सेम लाइंस आई एम गोइंग टू टच एनीथिंग दे आर गोइंग टू प्ले विद व्हाटएवर इज देयर सो अर्लियर इट साउंडेड धुक धुक ता क्या क्या ऑल दैट वाज हैपनिंग Next band came, the same equipment.
Coffees?
Yeah. Same sound, same PA, same sound engineer. It started sounding dum dum tak tak dum dum.
Thank you.
So how much of a source is important? How much of a musician who is sitting on the source, you know?
Is
the most important thing.
Correct.
Then, once that is good, then our work starts.
Correct.
If that is bad, we can't do a shit. Shit, I can't do anything.
And, man. That changes the way because we recently I went to this recording for a band and the sound check itself took an hour I think probably because it was just not vibing it was just not set to that degree and I constantly went like yare equipment mein kuch hai kya
equipment is the last thing it is first discipline the individual discipline setting up tones for that amplifier they get You know, all that correct. Understanding, basically understanding your instrument and giving correct sound out from two lines out. That's what it is all about. Like if you're a keyboardist and your patches are not, I mean, that if I have to tell you.
Then what is the point of that?
Oh, you are a keyboardist, correct. You should check all the patches before, you know, coming in. Here is very loud, here is a little bit, I can understand with backing tracks, some are a little loud, mastering ka thoda idhar ho gaya, ho gaya. But even that has to be checked before coming here.
Amazing.
You know, but still. देन अरे थोड़ा ये कम कर थोड़ा ये पैच थोड़ा लाउड है सोलो पैच अरे इज नॉट इनफ लाउड सो ऑल दैट इफ यू हैव टू डू देयर आई वाज टेलिंग यू आई हैव टू डू एनीथिंग आई पुट द गेन अप एंड द की वाज साउंडिंग गुड
सो द गोल
इज ट्यून्ड इट परफेक्टली
एग्जैक्ट
एवरीथिंग वाज ट्यून्ड व्हाटएवर टाइम इट टुक बिफोर हैंड 15-20 मिनट्स व्हेन ही वाज वर्किंग ऑन इट ही डिड हिज जॉब
टू परफेक्शन एंड देन कलर्स
टू Yes, I didn't have to do
best.
Although, अरे mic दे नीचे गया क्या ऊपर गया.
That's the best. Yeah. What is your worst experience? That of course.
Worst, I did one metal band का competition. That was the first and the last.
Battle of the bands.
First and the last time I ever was involved in something. Because there the attitude, I was telling you, one guitarist comes, connects, on.
Yeah.
No. I can't hear anything. Hey, on the mic because mic is on. He's telling me, "Hello, I can't hear anything."
Oh my God!
Have you asked for anything?
Correct.
No. Please ask for something. Then I'll give you. I have given people hard time from the.
Yeah, dude. So, as you should.
Done. Yeah.
दो बार जब कोई सुनेगा तब जाके वो सीखेगा जरा.
Then once I went in, I briefed them. This is how a sound check is done. So when you go in, if you're new, don't show your fucking attitude.
Correct.
He's going to work with you. He's your friend. Don't show him attitude.
Exactly.
Whoever is there. Whenever I go and do this workshops for you know musicians or about live shows and doing the most important thing I talk about is sound check. How disciplined you are at the sound check will
shows
decide what sound. Everybody I have saw cribbing about are yaar sound nahi acha mila. That's why we didn't perform well. Tumne kya kiya?
Exactly. Help me help you.
Have you done? लाइक उधर गए थे उधर साउंड ही नहीं था एवरी वन कंप्लेनिंग बट दे डोंट ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड द डिसिप्लिन भाई गिटारिस्ट गया तो घर में रिहर्सल करना इधर रिहर्सल करना नहीं आए यू आर सपोज्ड टू सेट योर टोन एंड शट अप
ओके
यू नो द सेम विद पर्कशन प्लेयर्स तबला प्लेयर्स दे विल नॉट स्टॉप नॉन स्टॉप दे विल कंटिन्यू प्लेइंग समथिंग
ऑल ही आदत है
इधर भी उधर भी
आदत है बजाते रहो वाला आदत है
जैसे जाता ही नहीं सो देन यू लिटरली हैव टू टेक माइक इन योर हैंड एंड बॉस बट आई हैव डन वंस टू इंडियन ओशन आल्सो They are old school, no? They have been doing it and so nobody can tell them anything, you know?
Correct.
Out of respect.
Of course.
And one day I had it. Nitin, I can't hear this. Can you hear this? And Nitin, all five mics on and everybody is talking to me. So I stood there. Nitin. Ho gaya sabka. If you want anything to be changed in your mix, I have two hands,
mm-hmm.
and I have two ears, and I can listen to only one person. Say, start, okay. Rahul bhai, bolo, kya chahiye? Then, uske baad next time onwards, okay. then...
No, but at least they've earned that position. Ye college rock band, matlab, apne ilake ka acha guitarist bol ke aa gaya.
Yeah, yeah.
And wo
no, but even at that level.
Correct.
No, I'm just talking about. So,
makes sense.
But then, I mean, that was one of... After that, now...
So, what about these workshops that you do? Like, do you conduct them in person?
Not on a regular basis. Like, there are a couple of institutes who call me to do a workshop, just talking to the students about all that kind of
sound
stuff.
Training,
like, whenever I get an opportunity,
because
I like to share the knowledge.
Exactly.
I mean, like, sharing the experience. I cannot teach people because I have not learned. So everything comes from experience, you know.
Correct.
So I share my experience.
So then, actually, for our audience, tell us how they can learn if they're interested, if they really want to chase sound and like musicians.
Live sound, if you want to, you have to be at the live sound venue.
Mm-hmm.
And I've let a lot of people come in to gigs. Aaja, sir, mere ko dekhna hai, ye karna hai, wo karna hai. Aaja, 7:30, whatever, 6, 5:30 is the sound check.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sir, show kitne baje? 7:30. Okay. Wo 7:30 baje aa gaya.
Bahar, abhi kar.
Mere ko show dekhna hai. Tere ko sikhna hai, ye show dekhna hai. तो सीखना है तो साउंड चेक में सीखा जाता है. अभी मैं कुछ नहीं कर रहा व्हाट आई हैड टू डू आई हैड डन साउंड चेक. आई एम जस्ट यू नो छोटा मोटा कर रहा हूँ बट मेन वर्क आई हैव डन एट द साउंड चेक टाइम. आई हैव ट्यून्ड माय सिस्टम. आई हैव ट्यून्ड द मॉनिटर्स. आई हैव कट द फीडबैक फ्रॉम द मॉनिटर्स एंड इंडिविजुअली आई हैव मिक्स्ड. आई हैव डन 7 मिक्सेस ईच फॉर द 6 आर्टिस्ट एंड 1 फॉर द PA. आई वाज डूइंग ऑल दैट एंड यू मिस्ड ऑल दैट एंड इफ यू डोंट नो द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ दैट
then there
Please
is no
go.
Point. Correct.
So basically it has to be from the sound check time. That's where everything is done. You can hear, listen to the difference of how the source comes and what I do and what happens to it.
Correct.
Why I do it. Okay, all that is there. Like, you know, and training your ears and understanding this is the most
key.
Important thing for life.
Okay, guys. Best, yeah. So, matlab, आपका लिंक वगैरह डाल दूँ ना DM में, क्योंकि अगर किसी को इंटरेस्ट होगा
लिंक
आपका इंस्टाग्राम का वगैरह.
हाँ,
दिल ट्रबल लियो इफ दैट
कम्स. इट्स ऑल वंस यू आर ऑन सोशल मीडिया, दैट्स ओपन. नो, इट्स ओपन बुक. यू कांट हाइड फ्रॉम इट. यू कांट हैव अ सोशल मीडिया पेज एंड लॉक इट.
Correct.
You can't log a profile on a social media. Just don't understand why you are here.
Exactly. Huh? Just don't be there.
Private chat karna tu idhar kyun aaya.
Correct.
So I get a lot of friend requests. Say, then I go and check who is this guy sending me friend request.
Profile locked. But bye. Abhi ke abhi niklo. Where is the next ride to?
A long ride, Spiti.
Spiti.
Short rides anytime when I get time.
I mean, like you came from one right now at the bowling.
So it's just like that.
Okay.
Abhi, I was going to go to Kokan, but just 2 gigs came suddenly.
Mm-hmm.
So after a year, I'm getting some gigs. So.
Now is the time.
Let's earn some money. I've been spending a lot. Let's earn some money.
Brilliant.
Because this COVID has done savings pura ho gaya.
Mm-hmm, of course. Sabka hai, sir. Luckily,
my wife works as head of the department of biotechnology. Mm-hmm. Her salary is going up.
Oh, she's also from biotechnology.
Yeah.
Okay, guess.
And my daughter is also working in a publishing house.
Mm-hmm.
So.
चल रहा है मतलब
लाइक दैट.
बट थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस सर. इट हैज बीन अ प्लेजर बियॉन्ड वर्ड्स टू हैव यू ओवर.
आई
होप यू हैड अ गुड टाइम. वी डिड. वी रियली रियली डिड. थैंक यू. वर आउट.